Hello, 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 everybody, and welcome back to the Late Log Eye server. It has been a little while, hasn't it? Anybody that's been watching the channel knows why. Hopefully I don't disappear for ages again. I hope you're all having a good day. I am having a fantastic day. I've woken up nice and early, logged onto the server for the first time in what feels like forever, and came over to the shopping district because this is where we're working today. And this thing, I've got to show you this. This was made by Link, R2I7. Link, as always, to Link's channel in the description. Go and check out this, because not only do we have a little me and a little her and a happy St. Patrick's Day, we also have the rainbow with my pot of gold at the end of it. This is absolutely brilliant. Got a cloud up there, rainbow, everything like that. And this was built to kind of cheer me up, because she knew I'd been a bit miserable because I couldn't record. And she cheered me up immensely. And it's awesome. And thank you very, very much. And it is staying. I'm not taking this down. I think that's awesome. And it's a lovely bit of advertising for the shop. Speaking of, let us go inside and check. One. I spent hours getting these. Hours. One. Come on, people. Come and give me your diamonds. The beacon bases. Oh, we stole a beacon base. That is lovely. Anything in here? Nope. There we go. That's better. Lovely. Right. But yeah, what are we doing today? I shall tell you. We are extending the shopping district. Link has done fantastic work over there extending the boardwalk, but I don't want to take up any of that space over there, because I want to take up this space over here. I've been promising for ages that I would come by and kind of finish off what I started here with the landscaping, and I thought that was a perfect opportunity to create almost like a little courtyard slash garden over here. Because I also need to create a new shop. It's not really a shop. It's more of a, well, you'll see next episode. But you'll see why I don't want to put it along the main thoroughfare of shops over there. That will hopefully be coming next episode. I cannot, for the life of me, remember how big this square is, but it's reasonably big. And what we're going to do is we're going to have an entrance coming in there. We're also going to link up to Para's shop over there. I think there's space here to put in another small shop if somebody wants to, so I'm not going to do anything there. And then we can have shops off behind it and going in all directions there, which is lovely. I am going to put these diamonds away quickly, set up my work chests, and I'm going to replace all of that, I'm going to replace all of that nasty looking netherrack with some nice polished andesite to give us a marker. So I'm going to do that, and I will catch you guys in a second. Bye-zy-bye! Okay, guys, we're back. The rain has finally stopped, and I can show you the amazing amount of progress that I've made. As I said I would do, I have swapped out the border for polished andesite. I've also got in this thing here, which is kind of to mark out where the rest of the paths will go. So the interior of this border here will be made into a path. Probably going to go for this kind of design over here. I would zoom in, but I still don't have Optifine. Or I might pop over to Missy's Road and see what he's done, because it might be nice to get some continuity in there. Yeah, but it will probably involve cobble, stone bricks, gravel, that kind of thing. And then they will follow in there and there and there and there, so that you've got many, many different walkways going off. What else? In the centre here, I do want to have something. I'm not sure what. I was thinking maybe a custom tree or a fountain or something like that. But I'm also thinking that that might be, I don't know, a bit too big for in here. I don't want this to have like a focus point necessarily. I just want it to be somewhere nice for people to walk through. So I don't particularly want to draw their eye to anything. I want them to look at everything. So that's a problem for future Sin to work out what to do there. But yeah, next step is to kind of fill in these pathways so that we've got a better way of seeing this thing, is what I mean. I know what I mean. You know what I mean. You're all smart, intelligent people. That's why you watch me. Yeah. Oh, excuse me. Anyway, so I'm going to get on with that, and I will bring you guys back in once I've made some progress. Catch you guys in a second. Bye-zy-bye. Okay, everybody, I've brought you back in for a little progress update and a little bit of shameless self-promotion. This is the progress that I have made. You'll notice that I've created like this almost circular, as circular as you can in Minecraft, little bit here. I've decided not to put anything in the middle. I think this is going to flow a lot better without something in there. If I'd have made this much bigger, then we wouldn't have been able to have as nice a gardens kind of thing with less. We wouldn't have been able to have as many features in it and stuff like that. Now on to the shameless self-promotion. If anybody is interested in the way that I build and everything like that, not that I'm saying you should be, there's far, far better builders out there than I am. But I have just started a small build series. It's going to be intermittent, not going to be posting every week, just as and when I get an idea or inspiration or something like that. But you can always put your comments and suggestions down in the comment box. Hey, buddy. Of things that you want to see me build or design and stuff like that. Get out of here. Get out of here. Yeah. So if you want to see like how I build these paths, then, you know, first of all, you could probably just look. But yeah, if you want to see me build something like this and show you my process and stuff like that, then, you know, leave a comment and go and find the last build tutorial video I did and go and watch that and give it a like and everything like that, because yeah. Please. Thanks. Right, I'm going to finish this off and then I will bring you back in once it's all done. And I think then we can actually get started on some proper landscaping and stuff like that. So I will catch you guys in a second. Bye-zy-bye. Right, another little progress update, everyone. Everything is in. I've also put in some torches underneath these wall carpets. Probably the best way I can do it without breaking the look of the thing up too much. There's always the hopper trick where you dig down to place a torch, place a hopper, and then place a stone pressure plate on top of it. But then you do get a black border around the outside, whereas with this, no such worries. I am tempted to come back at some point and replace all of the torches with glowstone, purely because you get this fire animation coming through the top, which... Not my favourite. But I currently don't have the glowstone to do that. So, not yet. Not yet. I will have to beg, borrow, steal, pay for, or otherwise AFK at the witch farm. But yep, that is not coming today. Next up, I kind of think that rather than starting in these bits, I want to kind of bring the landscape back a bit. Just so that we can kind of see how this area is going to be kind of looking. I want to take these back here. I want to create a nice kind of way to get up to Para's shop. Probably come from... I think maybe we'll come out, because this isn't going to be walled or anything. I think we'll just come straight out from here and we'll kind of do this pathway again, just leading up to this level of his shop. I think that will be a good idea, but to do that I kind of need to knock back some of this landscape here. Kind of almost look like it's been cut away. I think that will work out there. Bring it back a bit, that works for me. I'm also going to take back everything from this level. I think that works. I think just having like this border here isn't something that looks particularly, I want to say natural, but I don't really mean natural. Brilliant, well done. It just looks like it's been cut in, and that's not the look I'm after. Let's bring in things like that here and there. And then once all that grows back again, that's going to look a lot better. I'm going to take this stone out here as well and replace it with grass. Yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do. So I'm going to crack on with this and I'll bring you back in for yet another progress update. I'm aware this has been getting a little bit progress update heavy, but I don't really know what else to do with this project. We might do some building on camera, stuff like that. So stick around for that. I'll catch you guys in a second. Bye. Okay, everybody, we are back. I have extended this pathway down a bit. I'm going to landscape these couple of little areas, I think, just to kind of bring them in, make them look a little bit less man-made. What else have I been doing? I have been adding in some dirt and grass blocks round about here, just to bring everything up to a level, as it were. That stretches all the way over here, right up until the side of my shop. There is a zombie somewhere. Zombie? this place under here is riddled with caves, and I haven't lit them up. What else have I done? Yes, I've taken down this entire mountainy, not mountain, little hillock over here, into the ground there. Because this is where I'm going to build my next thing, which I've been calling a shop. It's not really a shop per se, not like any of the others that are around here. It's going to be a community build, which will benefit me. Hopefully it'll benefit others too. But as I said, that is coming next episode. I've started doing a little bit of landscaping here. Let's just pop up. I know you're never going to see it from this angle, but we can just see what's going on. A little hillock there, sand and sandstone just to layer it up. A nice little pond here with some sugarcane, and that cactus will eventually grow up nice and tall. A couple of bushes, some bone meal, got some hidden lighting all the way around in there as well. The glowstone, not that hidden, but you get what I mean. And hopefully that will all be lit up. Next, I want to do this quadrant here, and I think I'm going to do it with you guys on camera. You will have seen me do this before. It's a technique that I adore, absolutely adore. Where is lovely? There is our stone. So let's get some of that going in like this. All I'm doing here is creating a boulder or a rock or something that is sticking out of the ground. That can actually stay there. Let's do this and that. Then what I'm going to want to do, I think, is actually take this away. Yeah. And extend this out. Take the bottom out of here, and that, and that, and then start filling the bottom of this area in, because I don't have any more stone. Do I have any more in my boxes? None in there. That's andesite. Yeah, we'll chuck some andesite in there as well. Why not? 1, 2, 3, 4. Lovely. It's exactly what I wanted. Then I'm going to take, I think, that away and that away. I'm going to add that back there and that there. I'm going to bring that out, and that is going to be stone as well when I go and get some. And then we're going to put that in there. Cannot right now, I'm afraid, AJ. I'm a little bit busy. And there's no bed here. I've been doing all of this in the dark, and I've been getting attacked by mobs and stuff like that. Right, so that is that in there. Me neither. Right, and let's grab... That's not what I want. I would like... Oh, I've got some of that in my inventory. Let's do some of this malarkey. Duke, duke. And let's also do some of that. And can I make stone buttons? No, I cannot make stone buttons out of cobblestone. That is very upsetting. Get that and that out of the way, and that and that there. And then do it, do it. So we're going to go like that. And then we can add these kind of things in here. And this starts to layer the build up a bit. We can swap some of this out for that. Like so. And then I think what I'm going to do now is I'm going to make a really, really quick cut. I'm going to go and grab myself some stone, some more water, and fill all this in and stuff. Let's actually make this a little bit less pointy. Yeah, that should do. That should do. So once I've done that, I will come back and I will show you what I've done. Catch you guys in a second. Bye. Right then, guys, I have got myself some more stone. I finished this off a little bit, put in some sand. What else have I done? Put in some buttons on this, like I like to do. Just gives it that tiny little bit more definition, a little bit more shape. Everything's been built up. I have put this dirt block behind here because I was meant to do... Can't do that because there is a button there. Move the button. Let's get that up like that. And... where's my string gone? My string's disappeared. I'm going to come back and put some string on top of that. That adds a nice little bit of height to it. I think also what we want to do is put another one there and keep that down low. Next up, I think I want to put some trees in this bit. Not too many, just a couple. Just to provide a little bit of height difference and stuff like that. So let's bone mill these. One. Perfect. And let's go for number two. Also perfect. Lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Two different ones. That's exactly what I wanted. As usual, we will go around bone mealing this area. Let's get some long grass in there. Taking out the flowers as we go. I'm also going to need to add in some more lighting around here. Oh, that looks better already, doesn't it? Wonderful, wonderful. Another thing that I want to do is add some vines. Those vines make everything happy and pretty and lovely. Let's put a couple on here. And let's go for one up there as well. They will eventually grow down and bring everything in. That's nice. It frames that mountain there in the distance really nicely. So let's just quickly run through here and see what everybody else is going to be seeing. That's not bad. That's not bad. I might have changed my mind about fencing this in. I'm not entirely sure. What I might do is to kind of continue the theme of the boardwalk. I might add these in around the side at intervals, just so that it's so it is a little bit more enclosed. I don't know. I'll try it out and I'll see what you guys think. How's about that? Right, I've got to carry on because I've got more work to do over there, and then try and get those lamps in. So I will catch you guys in a second. Bye. Hey, okay everybody, we are back and I am nearly finished with this project. As you can see, I've added a few more decorative features in the other quadrants, added some trees over there, and I've put in all these lighting, all these lamps, lantern things around the outside to mimic what we've got over there on the boardwalk, and I think that is probably the best way to go about this. I do really like them. It does kind of bring the area together and kind of keeps it as a separate area kind of thing, which I really, really like, actually. I wasn't going to do that originally, but it feels better. Feels much better. Next thing I've got to do is link up Para's shop here to the pathway here. I think I'm just going to do that by carrying on the inside of this design here and just have it lead up and have it fade out into his doorway. I think that is a good idea. So let's hop in. Do you know why I made this out of sand? I made this out of sand so that I could just do this and then come back in. I've been shooting zombies. As you do. That's why I did that. Thank you very much, Magoo. Thank you for going to sleep because This keeps happening with the mobs. Yep. So let us grab some stuff from our chests over here, hidden away. I need some stone. Do you know what? I'm going to take that polished andesite as well. There's some stone. Don't know why I've got cyan hardened clay on me. Need some of that. Yeah, we'll take some stone brick slabs. I don't really use them that often, so why not? And that and that. Right, let us do this. So I think let's bring the polished andesite out a bit. Like that and like that. We'll put another bit there and another bit there just to kind of make it look like it's broken up a little bit. We'll take those out and like that. Right, let's get some blocks on the bar. Stone, cobble, that and that. So first of all, we're going to go in with our stone and just... No, that is not where you go. That is not where I wanted you to go at all. And yet, there you went. Right, that there, that there. That there. Yeah, that there. Now some gravel. Fill that bit in there, like that. That should do for that. Fill the rest in, like so. And then we can start to go... Don't want one there? No. Now we can start to go up here. So let's take those two out. Cobble and a gravel. Do you know what? I really hate sheep. I'm not even sorry. Not in the slightest. And then let's bring that up like that. And I think we'll actually take that out a little bit more. So that starts to break the path line up a little bit. And then after this rise, we can start to really break it up. So cobble, cobble, gravel, stone, boop, 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 boop. And then from here, we can start to funnel it. And then we can start to just do little bits here and there. And maybe what we'll do is something like that. God, I hate this path block. Really hate it. Which is terrible. I can't get over it. I genuinely can't. I've tried so hard to like it. Because it is a really nice addition. It really is. But, yeah, I just can't do it. Can't do it at all. Did I already put stone in? No, I did not. So that's like that. And then under there we're going to need... Give me that. No, we don't want that. We really want some oak. I've got some back in my chest, so that is fine. Get rid of that. Stone bricks. And maybe one more out to the side like that. There we go. That's nice. I like that a lot. So as we don't intrude on Parish Shop too much, all I'm going to do for now is put some torches down for lighting. I don't know whether he had plans to extend this or not, and if I build too much, then that might put him off. So, Para, if you are watching, let me know. And if you're not going to extend that bit, then I will do some different lighting. But yeah, that is that all done. I need to get that oak wood slab, don't I? Oak wood. Da-da-da-da-da. Not in there. Not in there. Not in there. There we go. Lovely. Take you. And just go and place that underneath his stairs. And all of this shall be done. There we go. Nice. Nice. So that is this part of the project all completed. Oh, I forgot to mention, I've also been putting some coarse dirt in at the bases of these spruce trees. And I think that's really, really nice. Just a nice little detail there just to break things up. Nice. So yeah, next episode we will be working over here. Nice big building here. Nice big community building that everyone can come and use, and, you know, everything will be lovely. promise. So that is the end of today's episode. If you have enjoyed it, please feel free to leave a like. If you don't want to miss the rest of the series and, you know, the building that we put there, then hit that subscribe button. And remember to tell your mother about all of the beautiful landscaping we've got going on over here. I'll catch you guys in the next episode. Bye-zy-bye.